वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स इन द पीरियड ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज एंड मेजरमेंट फॉर ICSE 7th स्टैंडर्ड. आई हैव डिवाइडेड दिस चैप्टर इनटू फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ यूनिट्स SI यूनिट्स एंड देन एरिया वॉल्यूम एंड डेंसिटी. यू कैन सी SI सिस्टम ऑफ यूनिट्स शोन इन द पिक्चर. यूनिट्स आर देयर मीटर की किलोग्राम कैंडेला मोल एम्पियर केल्विन. And you also know time is measured using a clock, temperature using thermometer and light intensity using unit candela, distance meter using a scale or tape, mass is measured using the spring balance in the grocery store or vegetable sellers. This is thermometer. Amount of substance, number of molecules and atoms, they are measured using mole. Molecular level mass, number of particles are measured using the moles. Time using the clock and unit of time is second. We call time in second. We express time in second. Mass in the kg. So this all you know SI system of measurement of the physical quantities. Physical quantities are one that can be measured. जो जो हम measure कर सकते हैं उसको बोलते हैं physical quantities. Use of words high, low, hot, cold does not show accuracy in measurement. We need a number and a unit to express the quantity very accurately. Suppose using a scale, we are measuring the length 25 meter. Then length is 25 times a meter. It is accurately close to the real length 25. So number and a unit is very important while measuring the physical quantities. Various physical quantities we have studied. They are mass, length, time, current, luminous intensity, amount of substance. These are the some fundamental quantities in the SI system of units. From the basic quantities in physics and science, we say we can calculate derived quantities. Now let us study in detail. There are different instruments we use to measure the physical quantities. Scale is used to measure the distance. Clock is used to measure the time. And balance is used to measure the mass. This is the balance used for measurement in the shops. This is a balancing scale. This is old balancing scale. This is clock to measure time, thermometer. Again I am revising. See. This is also used to measure the mass. This is a digital meter in place of its balance to measure mass. In this chapter, we will study in details how to measure space occupied by object of any shape. And the space occupied by the object having length, height and breadth is known as volume. And the space occupied by any object having the length and breadth only is known as the area. Every object occupies the space. The object may be solid, liquid or gas. We can measure the volume of liquids using the measuring cylinders, cups or beakers. Like volume of a milk, petrol, kerosene using the beakers. Volume of regular shaped solids can be measured using formulae. And first we will study measurement of volume of liquids using measuring cups, cylinders and measuring beakers. Solids, liquids and gases. There are three states of matter, solids, liquids and gases, and they occupy the space. This space is known as the volume. वी मेजर द एरिया ऑफ लैंड फॉर हाउस गार्डन एंड वॉल्यूम ऑफ मिल्क वाटर पेट्रोल डीजल एक्सेट्रा. वॉल्यूम इज द स्पेस ऑक्युपाइड बाय द ऑब्जेक्ट. इफ दिस कप हैज कैपेसिटी 500 ml देन वॉल्यूम ऑफ लिक्विड इन दिस कप इज 500 ml. इफ टू कप्स आर टेकन देन वॉल्यूम इज 1000 ml. टू एंड हाफ विल मेक 750 ml. दिस इज द मेजरिंग कप यूज इन आवर हाउसेज टू मेजर द वॉल्यूम ऑफ लिक्विड. मेजरिंग सिलेंडर इज शोन इन नेक्स्ट डायग्राम. इट मेजर्स द वॉल्यूम इन आउंस एंड मिलीमीटर. दिस इज द यूनिट लाइक मीटर केजी सेकेंड. यूनिट फॉर मेजरिंग द वॉल्यूम ऑफ लिक्विड इज आउंस. डिफरेंट इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स आर शोन टू मेजर द वॉल्यूम. दिस इज द फार्मास्यूटिकल फ्लास्क यूज इन फार्मेसी मेडिकल फील्ड मेडिसिंस प्रोडक्शन टू मेजर द वॉल्यूम ऑफ केमिकल्स. दिस इज द मेजरिंग बीकर्स यूज बाय मिल्क मेड पर्सन टू मेजर द मिल्क समटाइम्स पेट्रोल केरोसिन्स. दिस इज द मेजरिंग कप. दिस इज मेजरिंग सिलेंडर on which scale is there. Capacity of beaker is known. We can use this value to measure the different liquids. If capacity is 200 ml, we can measure up to 200 ml. 200 ml of two cups will make the 400 ml, and so on. Three will make 600 ml. Beakers are available in the market. We can use from smallest to largest as availability to measure the volume of milk, kerosene, petrol, etc. Suppose we have 100 ml of beaker, then 100 ml into 10 will make 1000 ml. Let us measure volume of irregular shape object. Take liquid of 7 ml in the first beaker, and now see, when we dip the irregular shape object like a stone, then if the level goes up to the 9 ml, then volume is increased from 7 to 9, means by 2 ml. This 2 ml is the volume of a stone. Again see, before dipping the stone, first beaker is showing the level 7 ml of liquid. After dipping the stone, level rise to 9 ml. This means that 2 ml increase is due to the volume of a stone occupied in the liquid. Hence, volume of a stone which has irregular shape is equal to 2 ml. We can also use two cylinders, one with a tap, to measure the volume of an irregular shape object. Consider the two measuring cylinders. One cylinder is kept under the tap of another cylinder. Now let us dip the irregular shape object, for example a stone. Liquid level will increase. Increase in the level is the volume. There is another example for practice. Suppose we dip a irregular shape object, suppose a stone tied to a string. And before dipping, if level is up to 200 ml, and after dipping, as soon as we dip the stone, if level goes to 260 ml, then increase is 260 minus 60, that is equal to 60 ml. This 60 ml is the volume of a stone, and hence we can calculate the volume of a stone like this experiment. In the next video, we will study about volume and area and density. Thank you.